Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Visual Arts Diploma Orientation session. Thank you for joining. I'd like to introduce myself. My name is Amara Wong, and I'm one of the academic advisors for the Fine Arts programs. And Paula Funk is the other Fine Arts advisor. So together we work to support you and your educational planning, and that can involve helping you clarify your educational goals, develop academic success skills, and access available resources. So this presentation is for you if you've already been admitted or conditionally admitted to the Visual Arts Diploma. If you're not yet in the Visual Arts Diploma but intend to complete it, this presentation is also for you. So today we're going to cover five topics. We'll start with discussing the admission status, the program structure and options, how to track your progress, how do you select courses and links for success. And then at the end, we will have time for questions and answers. Okay, so let's start with the admission status. So at this point, your portfolio has been submitted and reviewed, and any post-secondary or past high school transcripts have already been received. If you're an international student, any international study permits have been secured. If you just recently graduated high school in June, then the only outstanding item should be your high school transcripts for 2023 grads. One important thing, if you are graduating this year, just remember to check off the option to have your grades updated so that an updated copy of your student record will be sent to us in early August. Okay, so if you were not admitted to the Visual Arts Diploma, you could still study at UFV this fall and make progress towards the diploma. Please make sure that you carefully review the communication from admissions and follow any instructions for requesting an alternative pathway. So we have what's called qualifying studies at UFE, and that's a good place to start if you're not quite meeting entrance requirements or maybe you missed an application deadline. So qualifying studies is a category at UFE that will allow you to take courses, any courses, as long as you meet those course prerequisites. If you have further questions about that or you need assistance, you can reach out to myself or Paula, and our email addresses are listed there at the bottom. All right, let's talk a little bit about the program structure. So the structure of the Visual Arts Diploma, it's 60 credits, and it focuses on four different areas of study. So you have a writing requirement, your studio requirements, some art history requirements, and electives in fine arts related subjects. So, as a visual, you're looking at about 10 studio courses, which makes up a huge portion of the diploma. And you've got five art history courses and four electives, and then one English writing course. So, altogether, that's 20 courses. So, in the diploma, you do take progressive studio studies. So, you start with four foundation courses, and then you can pick your studio core in a blend of different disciplines. So, you might consider painting and drawing, print media, or photography. We offer sculpture and video production. When you get to the 200 level, you can choose your studio disciplines from among this list. If you're thinking of laddering into the Bachelor of Fine Arts degree later on, you should meet with either Paula or myself to make sure that you have the prerequisites for the upper level classes to specialize in three studio disciplines. That's for the degree. Okay, tracking your progress. So, the simplest way to view degree requirements and seeing what you've completed is by using My Grad Plan. So it is an online tracking tool that you have access to in your MyUFE account. So when you log into your MyUFE on the homepage on the right side, you'll see My Grad Plan, And you'll want to click on that green hyperlink that says Students, click here to learn more. Then you'll scroll down to the bottom of the page and click Access Your Personal MyGrad Plan here. We do have tutorials. Make sure that you review the tutorial on what if and the lookup features. That will help you with your program planning. If you do have questions, then feel free to book an advising appointment, and Paula and myself can go over that feature with you. There are other tracking tools as well, so it can be useful to cross-reference what you see in MyGrad Plan with other worksheets for course planning. On our Advising Center website, we do have some program plans. They are spreadsheets that you might find useful. If you meet with Paula or myself, we'll likely supply you with a program plan spreadsheet as a supplemental tool for course planning. But keep in mind that MyGrad Plan is the official tracker and the tool used to approve your graduation. All right, let's talk about fall course planning. So you might be wondering, what should I take in my first semester? It's usually recommended that you blend some requirements with an exploration of interests in areas you might want to pursue later on. So the choice is really up to you. As a recommendation, you might want to consider an English writing course, a 100 level foundation requirement, like maybe a visual arts course in painting or drawing, and an art history course. So here's a sample fall semester. This is four courses. We've got an art history, a communications course, and then two visual arts courses. All right, so preparing to register. There are a few steps involved with the registration process, and there is a link there on those steps. I highly recommend you check that out. You will need to pay a $200 registration deposit before you can register. And there is information on that page that will tell you how you can pay. There are also really useful tutorial videos on how to read the timetable. And our Future Students Office frequently runs information sessions on how to register for courses. So I encourage you to check one of those sessions out as well. All right, you might have questions about workload. So if this is your first year, students usually take between three or four courses to start. That can equal about 9 to 12 hours per week in class. So on average, we recommend that for every hour you're in class, you're putting in about 2 to 3 hours of homework outside. So for example, if you're taking three classes, that's approximately 20 or more hours per week of schoolwork, both in and outside of the classroom. So you'll have to factor that with any other responsibilities you have as well. Maybe you're working, maybe you have family commitments. So those are all things to keep in mind. I usually recommend that you start with less, and you can always add more classes in future semesters, but really important not to overload yourself in the first semester. All right, a few points actually to consider when you're planning your course load. If you need student loans, you will be required to take at least 3 courses or 9 credits per semester to be eligible for a loan. Outside of that, if you're not on loans, you're certainly welcome to take as few as 1 course or as many as 5. And you can take breaks in between semesters, so you can stop out for up to 1 calendar year and still retain your student status. So if you are gone for more than 1 year without registering, then at that point you would need to reapply to UFV. All right, we have some excellent resources at UFV that I'd like to discuss. So finding your place, our students have many opportunities to be part of the creative community. We've got student associations in visual arts, graphic design, theater. We've got a lot of student clubs that you can join. There are gallery field trips that are planned for all fine arts students and media students every semester. And there are regional and national artists that visit UFV to deliver artist talks. So I highly encourage you to check those out and get involved. It's a great way to meet your peers and faculty as well. All right, so navigating our student tools. There are a few links here to tools that are going to be essential for your success here at UFE. So you'll want to know how to navigate the academic calendar, your MyUFE account, and the Advising Center website. So I will give a short demo on how to navigate through each of these. The first one is the academic calendar, and that's a manual for all courses and programs at UFE. All right, so I'm just going to exit out of here. All right, so when you are on our homepage, if you go to the upper right-hand corner, you'll see the word calendar. If you click on that, this is where you can look up any program or any courses at UFE. So under select area of study, if we type in visual arts, this will pull up the various programs. So if we click on visual arts diploma, we can see all of the entrance requirements, how to apply, and program outline, so all the courses needed. So you can search any program in the calendar. You can also find a list of courses offered. So if we look for, let's say, visual arts, this will show the course description for a course as well as any prerequisites. So the prerequisites are important to pay attention to because those will tell you if there are any other courses that you're required to take before. Another thing that you can do in the calendar is find the course outlines. So if we look for visual arts, the course outlines will give you detailed information about not just the calendar's description, but also learning outcomes and the course content and topics, and even the evaluation methods and weighting. So, if you're wanting some more detailed information about a course, you can certainly look that up under the course outlines. All right, so that's the calendar. Next is your MyUFE portal. So this is really important for everything to do with registration and for finding your MyGrad plan. So once you've logged in, this is where you'll find MyGrad plan, which we were talking about. Your student number will automatically populate, and this is where you will find a list of courses needed for your program. If we go back under self-service links, student information, this is an important area where you can check your registration time once it's been posted, as well as this is where you will add, drop, or waitlist courses. Any information about student billing and accounts can also be found under this fourth tab. All right, lastly, I just wanted to go over our academic advising website. So this is our homepage. If you ever need to book an appointment, we've got a button for that right on our homepage. Connect with an advisor. So if you're a current student, you'll want to click on this button, Book Completion Program Advisor, and then find your program. So if we pick Fine Arts, you have the option to book in person or virtual. And then this is where you'll see Paula and I. And then you can select the times. You can see the days and times and book an appointment that works for your calendar. All right. So, of course, if you need any more information or if you need tips, you can email advising@ufv.ca, or you can book an appointment with Paula and I, and we can help answer your questions. It is recommended probably to book an appointment at least once a year or every 30 credits. Booking before your registration time is the best. So, for example, if you are wanting to discuss course planning for fall, you want to be booking an appointment sometime in May. To discuss course planning for winter, you would want to book an appointment sometime in late October. All right, so this ends the presentation. I know that's a lot of information that we covered. Feel free to reach out and we can help answer any further questions you have. We hope that you're feeling confident and excited. It's okay to feel a little anxiety. That's completely normal. But of course, if it grows into something more troubling, or if you're finding you need some support, please reach out. Paul and I are your people of contact at UFV, and we look forward to working with you.